Or they decided
to start. Newspaper said
they know we're playing a single player version, so
really?
That's actually he's connected to his laptop over our local network. It's configured in the but yeah, this is our wireless setup. We actually bought this laptop to enable the last. I guess I can talk to them about that stuff.
Well, pretend that someone's using it and someone else just walked up and said, hey, tell me about the game. I got like 5 minutes.
What's this?
5, 10 minutes.
Sure.
Without getting sued.
Yeah. Do you really want me to? I mean, we've done that before. Hello, sir.
That is the exercise for this week.
All right, sir. So, yes, thank you for coming by. The name of our project is Project Holodeck. We're building a fully 360-degree virtual reality video game console, which has kind of a large two-player play space.
Can you guys hear Nathan okay back there?
Yes, hello, sir. Sirs and madams. As you can see, I'm wearing what we have, which is basically the console. Yeah, I guess I'll kind of explain some of it while we try to get it working. We have kind of a pre-Oculus Rift head mount here. It's called the Socket HMD. It's from the Mixed Reality Lab. We have this PlayStation Move, which tracks position and orientation. We have this other PS1, which tracks orientation. We also have the Razer Hydra, which this is actually how you control your hands. What this does is allow us to have a play space that's roughly the size of this camera, and then you can walk all the way over here, and then you can lean forward, and then you can go here. So you actually increase your actual play space to be like really, really, really large. And it gives you low latency tracking for the most important points of your body in the space. And so with that, you can basically make anything. And what we're making is an airship game called Wild Skies that two people can play together. And the networking side of that is very hard. We have to have a server running that two clients in each of these backpacks. This is a laptop in here. It's like a Lenovo laptop that we have. Actually, I'll tell you about that because I just bought it. There's 18 battery cells and an SSD, so it's like specially designed for virtual reality.
Yeah. Lasts for 52 hours.
Really?
So without the gameplay.
Okay. And so basically, we'll have two of those running and then a server as well. And so then also be synced up in a classic server architecture. Oh, here we go.
Right.
Black.
Okay, thank you.
Still black.
Yeah.
So yeah, so like the whole idea here is you have 6 degrees of freedom tracking of the hands with the Hydra, and then 6 degrees freedom tracking of the head with the PlayStation Move. So you can actually move around in a full three-dimensional space and be completely engaged. So we have a lot of different interactions on the deck of the airship. And the deck of the airship is actually a 1-1 scale with your actual play zone. So if you share the deck with another player who has another holodeck suit on, then you could both be sharing a physical and virtual space simultaneously. So if you bump into them, you'll see their avatar in the virtual reality, and you'll also feel their physical body. So there's sort of a tactile immersion there as well. There's a lot of different interactions on the ship. We have weapons on the ship like cannons, turrets, and that kind of thing. We also have a lot of different ship controls that you can use. We have like an altimeter that adjusts the altitude. There's a flight stick that allows you to fly the ship around throughout the macro world. And then we also have like a periscope. Is there anything else? There's the afterburner and a bomb bay.
There's
a lot of
holograms
on
the ship that allow you to kind of read out to certain things.
Yeah, and we're trying new stuff.
Because everyone's here, we should show a build of just not the virtual part.
Yeah, maybe we could project it up on the projector without the HMD.
I think it's just to show something.
You want me to help you take that?
Yeah, it's part of my wedding dress.
Yes, sir.
Does anyone have any questions?
Yeah, anybody have any,
a
lot of the
members
newcomers?
Of the other teams that just came in, so.
Yeah, are you guys, are from the other teams, do you have any thoughts on, or questions about the technology we're using, or questions for our team? Oh, Graham, he wants to know if it's black.
Yeah, black.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, I'll just.
Yes, which one?
Just my black laptop.
I don't see a laptop bag. Oh, it's in the back here.
There's a bunch of these.
This is mine.
That's here.
Yeah.
Give me a mouse.
Oh, we're going off to the rescue.
Yeah, we'll have the networking working. We literally just got it working with the last year.
So, what's the big deal? Can we just do it local? Can we just do client only for case things?
You can't run single player.
I don't know.
And what have you built
So yeah, that's actually what the HMD would see. Barrel warp to be able to show. It's actually just it's one screen and two lenses inside of this. And it actually uses that warping to be able to show you what the game looks like in virtual reality. Yeah.
And I will actually set it to my head.
So one of the cameras, so the idea with the game is that we have it, the server actually will project onto a projector, and then you'll be able to see a number of views. Some of those are views outside the ship, some of them are actually views of the player's seat. And this is what the ship looks like. So this space seems small in a game. This space roughly represents that space right there. So if I was standing right here, I would actually be standing right about there. And then you can actually, you can turn around and walk to the back of the ship. And that's where the illustrious professors are standing, is right about here. And right now we just kind of have a simple demo that shows off some of the gameplay that we have working. Mainly just kind of flying around. We have these balloon mines that we have as kind of markers in the world. You can shoot them with this kind of handgun that we have. There's a number of enemy ships as well, which kind of respond to you in a number of different ways. And they can also explode. They're not very good flying right now.
So those are balloon mines, and they'll cause your ship to crash and burn.
Actually, yeah.
Is that the scout?
This is the balloon ship, I think. So this actually will shoot. Yeah, this launches balloons out. And so a lot of the gameplay involves ship-to-ship combat, as well as enemy combat. Moving around the space obviously is a lot different than massive people. Very easy to die. So yeah, like I said, you can't just move around like this in virtual reality. It's actually kind of much more of a rush as you actually have to move around in the real space.
Oh jeez.
Follow me. So a number of things we're also working with. Is holograms. So we think holograms look really cool in virtual reality. So in 3D, that actually looks a lot neater. And we're kind of working with using holographic interfaces on the ship as well as in other areas. And other kind of experiences we want to use, kind of just make use of a lot of holograms. People want to have holograms in real life where they can, and for obvious reasons, yeah. And but in virtual reality, you can make all sorts of different things. So those kinds of interfaces are very interesting to us.
Yeah, and the nice thing about having a hologram really close to you is that the experience of parallax is a lot more intriguing when it's up close. So when you see an object floating in front of your eyes within the 3-foot range, you can actually look around it in stereoscopic 3D and get a strong sense of depth. So we're thinking for the hologram that circles around you on the deck, you can actually have a radar system where if you see like an enemy ship in the distance, if you're within the sphere of the hologram, you can have like a little red dot or a blinky cross symbol or something that overlays on top of the enemy ship that's in the distance, and it can give you an idea of how far away it is, its movement and that kind of thing.
So another piece of our game we're working right now, we're close, is ship-to-ship combat where you actually have enemies board your ship. That's actually a scout ship. So yeah, the idea with the scout ship is that enemy AIs will actually interact with your ship and jump on your ship when you have to sword fight them. So they actually tether onto your ship, and they also can destroy you pretty easily. So I think I got hit by something. So that's the basic idea of the game. It's kind of a combination of macro and micro space. Graham, how's it going?
I think I'm
headway or no?
I think I'm better running.
Did you?
Almost.
What are the big pushes for next semester?
I go to running. Can you give me?
Well, the big pushes for next semester, obviously, there's finish the goals that we had for this semester. So there's two players, networks. We want to have a robust.
Right, so we're picking up a second HMD on Friday so we can finally finish off our second holodeck system. So the big push for demo day is to have two players in virtual reality sharing space over network, which is going to be really, really fun to play around with. Up until now, we've just been having variations where you have one person in complete holodeck system, the other person is just playing Razer Hydra on a laptop or doing with mouse and keyboard, that kind of thing. So finally seeing how two players interact together to tell the narrative is going to be a huge breakthrough for us.
Yeah, and we're creating a robust API that we can make a lot of different experiences, and they're kind of very easy to sit on your laptop and make an experience and put it into the holodeck. That's the whole kind of idea. And actually,
can you hit start on the right controller? You're destroying me with the mouse right now.
What?
On the computer on your back. The Hydra. Using the mouse.
Oh, my bad. Good?
Yeah, thank you.
Right. So actually, yeah, we're going to get this working in a second, so you guys can try this out while we still have time.
What about the big risk for next semester?
So the rest of the goals. So basically, we want to complete Wild Skies as an interactive experience. We want to have 5 to 10 minutes of gameplay. We want to have narrative, which is really hard. It's really hard to make narrative in student projects when you don't have the ability to control the camera, and because of that, things end up getting harder. A lot of the cues you normally would use are actually not as available, and so because of that, we ended up taking any of the story things out of this, and we just have some basic gameplay. So we want to have the fundamental tools to be able to build a narrative, and build a narrative out of that. What's that? It's on again?
Yeah.
Right hand? Good?
No.
Left hand?
That should look a lot tougher than it was.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's it looked pretty tough.
It almost killed me.
So we want to complete Wild Skies as an experience. We also want to make a few other experiences to kind of just see, this is a completely new medium, so what works, what doesn't, what's fun, how do people feel in the medium. We also want to just make the system very robust. We're definitely on a way that we just got it working untethered, which is really, really important.
Yeah, finally, for the first time, we're able to experience it with the laptop on the back, so you don't actually have to be tethered to anything.
That's cool.
So as long as you're within range of the camera, you can move around.
Where is it?
So another big goal is setting up our art pipeline with Noman. I know we talked a little bit about that.
Yeah.
And getting a solid amount of art assets into each of our four scenarios that we're setting up. This is pretty close to the final space we want to make, but obviously we want to have a unique visual appeal that's not just looking like Unity. So that's a really big deal to us as well.
If you said it's working like 2 minutes.
Less than that.
So what was the problem?
What about risks?
Like we talked about, the networking is potentially a risk when it comes to having two players working together on a shared space.
Okay.
If we do want to go as far as implementing a multi-camera system so that an audience can view the world and
and see what's going on while the other players are playing.
Yes.
That'll be an interesting challenge. To see where that goes.
Can you plug my
another big thing is getting all the animations that we need, including NPC animations and especially player animations. One tough challenge with the player animations is having motion tracked real-time animation of the hands and torso while simultaneously having traditional animation of the legs and everything else. So you have a shared system of animation and making that feel natural and look natural to both players and audiences is going to be a challenge.
Alright, so we're still having a few issues, but it's basically working now, so we can have...
Did you want to do it, Scott?
Sorry, me?
Yeah.
We have like 4 minutes.
I don't think we have enough time to...
Okay.
Sure. But I've done it twice, so if anybody else wants to...
Okay, does
anybody
else
wants to try, it's... There's a number of issues, but it's basically working.
It's really cool. It's, I mean, it's...
Someone be brave.
If anyone wants to try it, you guys don't have to leave when the professors leave, so we can take a few extra minutes.
Josh,
I'll try it.
No, I want
to try
it.
Let's try it. Someone raise their hand over there.
Cameron was it.
Cameron wants to try it.
Yeah, it's the camera.
Yeah, man.
I'm going to take yours, Richard.
Right.
Did Valky go over to THH?
Can
you go over to THH? All right,
just go ahead and do this number.
It should be in. The previous file should be out now. Right?
Yeah, just grab it
when you're all this thing set up. I think so.
Here's your pack.
Square.
Yeah.
Fire, yeah, but we